All right, let's do a little quiz.
Okay.
That to help us kind of make sense of the equations in the Keulerian equation by looking at a simpler case. So let's imagine that we've got some variable v and some sequence of values x and a sequence of learning rates, alpha sub t. So we're going to draw a series of these x values and use them to update the v values. And the learning rate is changing over time, and the learning rate is going to have the first of all, x is going to be drawn, x sub t, is going to be drawn from some the distribution of some random variable, big X.
Mm-hmm.
And the learning rates are going to satisfy two properties. One is that the sum of the learning rates summed up to infinity, but the sum of the squares of the learning rate as we go to infinity sums up to something less than infinity. So can you think of a learning rate sequence that has that property?
So the one that I remember is alpha sub t equals 1 over t.
Good. So in fact, there's a whole range of possible powers of t that work here, but 1 over t is a good one. Why does it satisfy the properties? Well, if you sum up the values up to some value t, sum up the 1 over I values, it actually acts like the natural logarithm. And so as t goes to infinity, the sum goes to infinity.
But logarithmically.
Which is still, you know, infinity.
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at the sums of the squares, that's actually a well-known problem called the Basel problem. And it turns out to actually be pi squared over 6, which is kind of crazy. But which is a finite value.
That's intuitively obvious, even to the most casual observer.
No, it's wacky. It was an open problem for a long time, and then it was finally solved. And it's like, yeah, sure, pi squared over 6. Like, where's the pi in here? There's no pi in there.
Mm, all right, but that's pi anywhere.
That's neither here nor there. The point is that there's a bunch of sequences of learning rates that satisfy this property, and we're going to imagine that we have a sequence of learning rates that satisfies this property. We're going to be updating v sub t with a series of x values drawn from some distribution, big X. And what I'm asking is, what do you think this converges to? Do you think it converges to the expected value of x? Do you think maybe it just doesn't converge at all? Do you think it converges to the variance of x? Of the random variable x, or does it converge to infinity? It just keeps growing without bound. All right, does that seem like a well-formed question?
Sure.
All right, so let's give you a chance to think about it.
Okay.